Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
tRNA or transfer RNA. It is also called as soluble RNA or sRNA certain times because it is difficult to centrifuge it. Whenever you mix mRNA, tRNA and RNA inside a centrifuge machine, it is very difficult to remove out tRNA during ultracentrifugation. Apart from that, tRNA plays a vital role during protein synthesis. How does that happen? We all know that on mRNA there are triplet codons present, and these triplet codons are nothing but messages which are just present at a particular distance on your mRNA. Now, for this codon, there is always an anticodon, and this anticodon is present on your tRNA or on your transfer RNA. So whenever mRNA is exposing its codon bases, at that time tRNA will expose its anticodon bases. And once an codon and anticodon matches together, then the codon and anticodon can be moved for a polypeptide synthesis, or you can say a protein synthesis. So main function of tRNA could be said that it transfers amino acids, or you can say it joins amino acids in such a fashion that your protein or chain of protein can be synthesized during in cytoplasm. Apart from that, tRNA has various arms, like it has the DHU arm, it has the acceptor arm, it has the anticodon arm, which does certain function. tRNA has certain structure, and the structure of tRNA is called as clover leaf structure, or you can say it is somewhat in symmetrical structure with the alphabet T. Apart from that, if you talk about tRNA, the synthesis of protein, or you can say DNA replication, is done inside nucleus, whereas protein synthesis is done inside cytoplasm. Now, once mRNA is formed by the process of transcription, then translation has to happen to synthesize your protein. And if I say that during the process of translation, your tRNA carries particular amino acids from each codon region of mRNA to its site in the cytoplasm for protein synthesis, so that will be function of your tRNA. tRNA, or you can call it transfer RNA. Now, tRNA is sometimes called as soluble RNA since it is very difficult to separate just tRNA from the mixture of mRNA and RNA if you just centrifuge them. Centrifuge is a machine which just mixes different types of biomolecules, and from that, tRNA cannot be separated. Now, the basic thing what tRNA does is it helps in the transfer of activated amino acid. When I say activated amino acid, it means whenever anticodon and codon combination is done, then an activated amino acid is formed. And this activated amino acid is transferred from the cytoplasm to the site of protein synthesis by tRNA or transfer RNA. So basically, you can see tRNA is a molecule that helps to move amino acids. Basically, there are specific amino acids present on mRNA, and this specific amino acid code, or you can say match with specific amino acids present on the tRNA. What do we mean by this? For example, if the static codon is AUG present on mRNA, then for tRNA, there will be a similar codon, or you can say opposite codon, which will match to it, which is its anticodon. The structure of tRNA is called as clover leaf structure, which is somewhat synonymous to the alphabet T. On the structure of tRNA, there is three triplet codon present for a codon present on mRNA, and this triplet codon is called as anticodon. This shows the structure of tRNA or transfer RNA. Now, this is called as cloverleaf structure. It has various parts, for example, the acceptor arm, T-loop, anticodon, and DHU loop. Let's see what each part does. The acceptor arm. Now, this is the acceptor arm to which your activated amino acids or polypeptides will attach, which will only happen when the anticodon loop on which the three triplet codons present will attach to the codons present on mRNA. Once the anticodon and codon pairing is done, then the acceptor arm will attach itself to the activated amino acids. Whereas your DHU loop has an unusual protein which is called as pyrimidine nucleotide. Or sometimes it consists of a pyrimidine nucleotide which is really unusual. T-loops helps in the transfer of this anticodon. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about tRNA. And how does tRNA help to carry an activated amino acid from cytoplasm to its site of protein synthesis? I hope you all are clear about this concept. Thank you.